Hi everyone, it's your boy The H, ready for another video, and as always I'm talking the comic, the sports and the wrestling. If you watch my other video, you know I've ordered a microphone. A couple of you guys were asking me to for clarity of voice, so that's what I've done. I've still got a little bit of a cold, so if my voice breaks halfway through, do not take it too badly and violate the vocal cords basically. Anyway, let's get straight to it. So later on tonight, it's going to be Sergey Kovalev versus Andre Ward. I'm going to break down the fight. This is a weird one for me because I'm going to give you like a tactical and technical analysis based on who I think will win, based on history and boxing skills and everything. And then my prediction is probably not going to actually go along those lines at all. And my prediction is probably going to be wrong. So you guys who follow me will be like, what's that about? But I'll explain, and you, like I said, you never know. It's a two-horse race, but sometimes you go with your heart, sometimes you go with your head. But let's work the head bit first, yeah? So, Sergey Kovalev, he is 36. Anthony Yard is 28. In that time, obviously, Kovalev has had a very distinguished career. And we're going to go into certain aspects of his fights as well. With Yard, we can't as much, because if we're being honest, Yard literally has beat guys like Travis Reeves. And if we're being straight up honest, Yard hasn't really fought anyone of the caliber. You could say he hasn't fought people of the caliber of Jose Burton or Joshua Buatsi. You could say that. And obviously, what a lot of people are saying, and what I've seen online, is he's never faced Joshua Buatsi, let alone Kovalev. He's never faced, he's never faced Callum. He's never faced Jose Burton, etc., etc. And while I do accept that, and I do understand that, on the other hand, and I'm not going to compare him to Tyson Fury, but when Tyson Fury fought Vladimir Klitschko, he got dropped by John McDermott, who did nothing really in boxing after that. He got troubled at times by Martin Rogan, aka the Cabman. He was known as the cabbie that boxed. I think he won prize fighter up on the original prize fighters. And Steve Cunningham, I forget if he rocked him or knocked him down, but either knocked down Fury or he actually rocked him. I think he knocked him down, and I think Fury came back and won. So obviously Fury was a good technical boxer, but he wasn't looking like a world beater. Literally, if you guys remember this, no one had him against beating Vlad. He was a huge underdog. Obviously, his boxing skills are different, so I'm not going to get into that. But my main point of that is, he beat Chisora, to be fair, he beat Chisora. So, except for Derek Chisora, who he beat, which is the top, at the time, I think it's top five, maybe, yeah, I think it's top five. Top five, top ten level heavyweight. Except for that, he was quite untested and he went in. So, on one hand, Yard has got the element of surprise. Anyway, let's go back on to Kovalev for a second. So Kovalev, on the other hand, hasn't got the element of surprise because he's been in the game for a long time. He's lost three times. The first fight against Andre Ward, a lot of people say was controversial. I've watched that about 7-8 times. You can see an argument for Kovalev to win. The people saying Kovalev easily won it, I don't know about that. Like, you could see it a split decision for Kovalev possibly. I wouldn't disagree with that. But the people saying, oh, Kovalev easily won that, I don't think we're watching the same fight. It wasn't an easy decision either way. The second fight, Ward definitely beat him up. And if you looked at the last round, even before the questionable possible low blows, Yard had him rocked. Yard had him badly rocked. If I remember, there was like a right hook. Freudian slip. Ward had him with like a right hook, and then he got him with some body punches. And people were saying he hit low, but a lot of his body punches were on the belt. They're on the belt line. Obviously, right at the end, if you're being honest, it did look like one or two were possibly low, probably low even, but by that time, Kovalev was already done, so he was ready to go. He might have lost another round, but it was a round 8 TKO by Andre Ward. But you know Ward is going to finish him then anyway. He adapted, and if you look at the skills which Andre Ward had, it was a good win. Should it have been 2-0? Possibly not. It probably should have been 1-1, because I probably would have been called up for the first win, and then it would have been a trilogy that would have been good to see. I think Ward probably would have won. But who knows? We're never to find out now, but it's good to conjecture and good to conversate about it, is it not? Yeah, so then we go to Eleida Alvarez. Alvarez KO'd Kovalev, if I remember what round. I think it was, I haven't watched this one again since it happened. I think it was seven. It was either seven or eight. But then what happened is Kovalev wasn't looking his best in that fight. Don't ask me why, but he wasn't looking in the best shape. He was looking a bit slow. I don't know what happened. I can't remember if there was any issues before the camp, but he wasn't looking himself. And the next fight, he came back and completely battered him. He completely dismantled Eleida Alvarez. I think it was a UD though. I think he won. I think he beat Alvarez in a rematch. Yeah, he outboxed him. I think it's a wide UD. I can't remember if it was 116, 110, or along those lines, maybe more. 118 it could even be, 116, 118. There were some huge scores. And basically, Kovalev just reminded everyone, oh, guys, don't forget, I can box. I once outboxed the great Bernard Hopkins. And oh, that is amazing. If you think about it, he outboxed Bernard Hopkins. He completely dismantled Jean Pascal in his prime. So if you look at the, just look at those, take those names, guys who Kovalev has either beaten or very well could have beaten. Andre Ward, Bernard Hopkins, Eleida Alvarez, who was unbeaten before Kovalev beat him in the rematch. And, yeah, and Hopkins, but Hopkins, like it's those four are stellar names. Whereas Yard, like Ward, sorry, Yard, I confused Ward and Yard so much, guys. Yard has literally fought, like I said, Travis Reeves and literally a bunch of journeymen whose names you won't even know. So based on that, you'd think, yeah, Kovalev's easily got this. And if you look tactically, Kovalev can box. He's orthodox, but he can switch it if he needs to. Rarely, but he can do. Good jab, great angles, movement. He looks susceptible in the second Andre Ward fight to body shots. So if Anthony Yard was looking at that, then he could hit him with some body shots to do some damage. But apart from being possibly a bit susceptible to that, it depends on what Kovalev turns up. If the same one that lost to Eleida Alvarez and got quite bullied turns up, he'll lose. If the same one that comes, but did show up in the rematch against Eleida Alvarez comes up, they'll probably win. But basically, most people for smart money would be on Kovalev to win tonight by UD, a big, wide, unanimous decision. That is where the money should go. And guess what? If I was going to bet on this fight, that's what I would do. I'm not going to bet on this fight because it's too close, and also because of a reason you'll soon find out in a second. Now, that's where I said the smart money will go. And that's what I said the prediction should be. That's not my prediction. I can't really give you good enough reason, but basically, with Anthony Yard, I follow the lad for. Basically, for everything he's come through in terms of the Maxi Muscle adverts, saw him in Boxing News, watched his videos with his manager Babatunde, aka Tunde Ajayi. And you know what? Maybe I've been a bit brainwashed. And you know, you guys all know me. I'm not that kind of guy to be like, oh, this guy's gonna win because he's English or he's British or whatever that rubbish. That's not about that. It doesn't matter what country you're from, whoever the best fighter is. Like, I'm gonna tell you guys straight up right now, Lomachenko will. I think TKO Luke Campbell in the later rounds. I'll give you a proper breakdown video for that soon. I believe he'll absolutely demolish Luke Campbell. I told you guys he'll beat Qualo within the first few, and he did. So it's not about that. I'll give Ruiz a good chance against Joshua. I'm not sure Joshua could obviously get a rematch. Depends if he's changed and changed his style and actually come a bit lighter. We'll see. But in terms of this fight, I don't know why. I don't know if he's a stupid. Lions in their camp, like shouting or talking or what. But for some reason, I just personally think Anthony Yard is going to come and surprise the world. I don't know why, and I'm probably wrong. And like I said, there won't be no apology if you do if I'm wrong, because like I said, logically, my head is fully telling me Kovalev will win this wide unanimous decision. That's what my head is saying. But for this one time, I'm going with my heart. I'm going with Anthony Yard. I'm saying he's going to win. He's going to do loads and loads of body shots. And I think Anthony Yard will KO Sergey Kovalev in round 10. You heard it here first, or what I voted for. But round 10, Anthony Yard, sustained body shots, too much pressure, too young, too much endurance, too much stamina. And he uses his strength, holds Kovalev a lot, pushes him off, and eventually finishes him with a devastating barrage to the body. That's my prediction. Will it probably be wrong? Highly likely, and it'll probably go completely opposite way. Like I said, I wouldn't be surprised. Let me know what you guys think. Good luck to Anthony Yard.